So the new album's going to be released soon. Excited and nervous, are you, as the release day approaches?
I'm excited but not nervous, but I know it's good and I hope it's received well, that's all, you know.
When he conceived Battle of Leningrad, what in particular prompted you to visit the struggle of the Russian people?
Well, I wasn't familiar with this story. You know, I'm kind of a history buff and I thought I knew a lot, but apparently this story kind of slipped past my radar, and Vitaly, who's the keyboardist in the band and co-writer, he's actually from Ukraine, so he has a little more direct background on that. Yeah, I was talking to Vitaly. We were talking about doing the album at the beginning, and he suggested doing a concept album, and I said, okay, cool. And he said, well, one idea he had was doing a story about the Siege of Leningrad. And I was like, what's that? I didn't know what it was. And so I did some studying. I read some books from the library. I took some books out of the library. I studied some stuff online. I looked at a lot of material. And it's really an incredible story, and it really... I think it lent itself to some really intense music, so I thought it'd be great for the album.
Do you have a favorite track on the album, then?
We have changes, you know. I like all the songs, but you know, they all. I don't know. It changes from day to day, from moment to moment.
So Ring of Fire, are there plans in 2014 for a tour in Europe?
Yes. Nothing definite yet, but we're putting out the feelers and trying to get something booked, and I think it's not going to be a problem. I'm sure we'll play some shows. I'm hoping we'll be able to do some festivals this year too, if it's not too late.
Yeah,
so we're really looking forward to touring the album, and when we do tour, we're going to bring a lot of multimedia stuff when we play the songs off of this album in particular, because I think it needs that. It'll really be a cool live performance, I think.
I can imagine. So you've got so many different projects, bands going. It was a bit confusing, actually. So which band do you enjoy playing with the most?
I enjoy all of it, you know. I've been doing a lot of recording lately because there wasn't much touring happening, and until a lot of these bands, it's really difficult for bands to do tours now because you have to be able to string a lot of dates together to make it, you know, not a losing proposition, and a lot of them can't do that. I think Ring of Fire is going to be fine for that because we have a history, and it'll be easier for us. So, but I love touring the most. But when I'm not touring, I can't stop doing music. So that's why I'm doing so much recording. I've been sitting in the studio but I'm a little tired of that. Now I want to get out and play live.
Absolutely, I can understand that. So, what's your views then on the current melodic metal scene?
Well, you know, it's different all around the world. I don't know. I think it's getting a little better. In the United States, there is not any scene. There's a lot of bands, and there's a lot of bands, but there's no scene. There's no, you know, there's not a lot of places for us to play, and not a lot of support from any actual scene happening. But, you know, in Europe, it's a little better, and in Asia, in South America, it's pretty good for American and European bands. Not good for Brazilian bands, unfortunately.
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy. It's kind of messed up. But, you know, I think it's getting a little better.
Uh-huh.
The whole music business, or lack thereof, is in a state of change right now. People are trying to adjust. The technology changes faster than the business can keep up with.
Totally.
So everybody's trying to, you know, figure out what the brave new world of music is going to be.
Uh-huh.
I think it'll settle down soon and into something where everybody can be a little more productive and viable.
Absolutely. Go back to the album. How long was the process with the writing and recording?
From beginning to end, it was about 3 months. It was, you know, some people say that's fast, some people say that's a long time, but I think that's pretty fast because I did a lot of that time was just studying, trying to wrap my head around the event, you know, and trying to get into the emotion of that time and those people at that time.
Do you think you'd like to actually take a show to Leningrad? It's not, is it called Leningrad still? It's not, is it?
It's called St. Petersburg.
That's
now.
Right, that's right. I knew that when I said it.
It's still the same city though.
That's
right. A different name.
That's right.
I played there with Rohan before a couple of times. Love to play there. That'd be fantastic. It would be perfect.
It would be really.
So we're trying. We're trying for that.
That'd be really moving, wouldn't it? I think that'd be really.
Yeah.
That'd be something else.
Attempt. Fear.
till everything's gone. Being with music 24/7, what do you listen to relax? Are you listening to rock and metal, or are you listening to different genres of music?
Oh, I listen to a lot of different stuff, you know. I listen to a lot of classical. I listen to a lot of new stuff that's coming out. I keep listening for bands to become original again. For me, the mainstream of rock bands right now, they're all sounding very generic. They sound almost the same. It's hard to tell even one singer from another singer. They're all singing the same. Everybody's playing the same, and I'm looking for. I would love to hear some bands to come out and just sound completely unique, uh-huh. as they did in the 70s and 80s, and even into the 90s. I think that's lacking in the music business today. But I'm listening for it. I'm looking for it.
That's brilliant.
I listen to jazz. I listen to a lot of stuff. I've always had an interest in just about every kind of good music there is. So.
Right, because Bring A Fire had quite a gap, haven't they, since they last released an album? Have you still got?
Yeah, we kind of fell off the wagon, I guess. The later albums of Ring of Fire, we kind of experimented a little too much. I think we went away from the original sound of the band, and that kind of got everybody lost. And everybody got busy with other things, and we just kind of forgot about it for a while. Uh-huh. Unfortunately. And thank goodness Serafino from Frontiers, the owner of Frontiers Records, just suggested it out of the blue to me. He said, why don't you make a Ring of Fire album? And I'm like, okay, you gonna give us a budget? Sure, he said. So I said, okay, let me call up the guys.
I see.
So I called everybody up, and everybody was like, yeah, yeah. And I was like, why didn't we do this before? I don't know.
That's brilliant. So do you envisage then releasing another album maybe next year, Ring of Fire? I mean, have you?
Yeah, why not? We had a good time with this one, and I'd love to continue on with the band.
Is there anything you'd like to say to your fans and our listeners?
Please check out the new album. If you've heard anything from Ring of Fire before, this is the best album we've done so far. And if you're not familiar with the band, check it out. It's a great piece of music, and I'm sure it's going to touch you in some way. Hi, this is Mark Bowles from Ring of Fire, and you're listening to the Metal Meltdown.
To a fool.